I am Ramesh. Presently I am working as a senior lecturer in mathematics, Narayana Junior College, Hyderabad. I completed my MSc and BEd from Kakatiya University. I have 18 years of experience in teaching in mathematics. So now I am going to explain about quadratic equations and expressions. Quadratic equations and expressions. So first of all, we have to learn what is the difference between a quadratic expression and a quadratic equation. So quadratic expression and quadratic equation. So quadratic expression, quadratic equation. Any expression of the form ax square plus bx plus c, any expression of the form ax square plus bx plus c, where a not equal to 0 comma b comma c, are real or complex numbers. Complex numbers is called a quadratic equation. So here a is not equal to 0, it is very most important. If a is equal to 0, what happens, sir? So then we get a linear expression. So that's what I'm going to explain about the quadratic equation and expressions. So for that purpose, here a not equal to 0, then we call as a quadratic expression. So suppose any complex number alpha is said to be, a zero of a quadratic expression, if a alpha square plus b alpha plus c is equal to zero. So similarly, quadratic equation also same definition here also. Any equation of the form ax square plus bx plus c is equal to zero, where a not equal to zero, b comma c belongs to real or complex numbers, is called a quadratic equation. Here also a not equal to 0. If a is equal to 0, then we get a linear equation. So here every quadratic equation, suppose alpha is a complex number, it is said to be a root or solution of a quadratic equation. Any complex number alpha is said to be a root or solution of a quadratic equation if a alpha square plus b alpha plus c is equal to 0. A alpha square plus b alpha plus c is equal to 0. For example, so 2 is a root or solution of x square minus 5x plus 6. Why? Because 2 square minus 5 into 2 plus 6, that is equal to 4 minus 10 plus 6, that is equal to 10 minus 10 is equal to 0. So that's why 2 is called a root or solution of a quadratic equation, x square minus 5x plus 6. So now every quadratic equation has two roots. So they are minus b plus or minus under root b square minus 4ac by 2a. The roots of the quadratic equation ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0 are minus b plus or minus under root b square minus 4ac by 2a. So now here the given equation is ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0. Now we have to prove these roots. So we have to multiply on both sides. I am multiplying on both sides by 4a. 4a into ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0 into 4a. So that is equal to 4a square x square plus 4abx plus 4ac is equal to 0. Here I am writing instead of this one 2ax whole square plus 2 into 2ax into b plus 4ac is equal to 0. So to make it perfect square, we have to add b square and subtracting b square. So 2ax whole square plus 2 into 2ax into b plus b square plus 4ac minus b square is equal to 0. Now the first three terms can be expressed as, so 2ax plus b whole square is equal to b square minus 4ac. So from here 2ax plus b is equal to plus or minus under root of b square minus 4ac. So 2ax is equal to minus b plus or minus under root b square minus 4ac. So therefore x is equal to minus b plus or minus under root b square minus 4ac by 2a. So these are the roots of the quadratic equation ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0. Okay, so here suppose let alpha is equal to alpha comma beta are the roots of a quadratic equation. Then sum of the roots alpha plus beta is equal to minus b by a, product of the roots alpha beta is equal to c by a. Sum of the roots and product of the roots alpha plus beta is equal to minus b by a, alpha beta is equal to c by a. So here now if these are the roots, suppose alpha comma beta are the roots of ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0, then ax square plus bx plus c is equal to a into x minus alpha into x minus beta, a into x minus alpha into x minus beta. And another one, if alpha comes the quadratic equation having the roots alpha comma beta is x square minus sum of the roots into x plus product of the roots is equal to 0. X square minus sum of the roots into x plus product of the roots is equal to 0. This is a quadratic equation having the roots alpha and beta. Alpha, beta roots are the roots of the equation x square minus sum of the roots into x plus product of the roots is equal to 0. So now these are the two roots of the quadratic equation. Here b square minus 4ac is there. This b square minus 4ac is nothing but discriminant of a quadratic equation, and that is denoted by delta. So now b square minus 4ac is called discriminant of a quadratic equation. So that is denoted by delta. Delta is equal to b square minus 4ac. It is nothing but a discriminant of a quadratic expression. So now the nature of the roots of a quadratic equation. First of all, nature of the roots of a quadratic equation ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0. So first one, if a is equal to c, then the roots are reciprocal to each other. If a plus b plus c is equal to 0, in this equation x square coefficient and x coefficient constant term, sum of these three is equal to 0, then the roots are 1 comma c by a. And next one, if a plus c is equal to b, then the roots are minus 1 and minus c by a. Are the roots of the equation x square plus bx plus c is equal to 0. And next one, if the roots are in the ratio m is to n, then mn b square is equal to ac into m plus n whole square. If the roots are in the ratio m is to n, then mn b square is equal to ac into m plus n whole square. If one root is nth power of the other, then a power n c whole power 1 by n plus 1 plus a c power n whole power 1 by n plus 1 plus b is equal to 0. So these are the nature of the roots of the quadratic equation, nature of the roots of a quadratic equation. So now nature of the roots. Here, nature of the roots means, suppose delta is nothing but b square minus 4ac, it is called a discriminant of a quadratic expression. Number one, if a not equal to 0, b comma c are real, then if delta less than 0, then the roots are roots are non-real complex numbers conjugate to each other. Roots are imaginary. Imaginary. Alpha plus r minus I beta conjugate complex numbers. If delta is equal to 0, then the roots are realigned equal. Roots are realigned equal. If delta greater than 0, then the roots are realigned distinct. Roots are realigned distinct. Suppose if a comma b comma c are rational, if a comma a not equal to 0, if a not equal to 0, b comma c are rational, then first condition, suppose delta less than 0, then the roots are non-real complex numbers conjugate to each other. So that means alpha plus r minus I beta. Suppose delta is equal to 0, the roots are rational and equal. Delta greater than 0 and it is a perfect square, then the roots are rational and distinct. Suppose delta greater than 0 and it is not a perfect square, then the roots are conjugate surds, that is alpha plus r minus root beta, beta not equal to 0. So this is the nature of the roots of the equation, nature of the quadratic equation. So now by using this simple concept, just what we have to learn now, up to now, just what is a quadratic equation, what is a quadratic expression, and what is the difference between a quadratic equation and quadratic expression. And next to roots of the quadratic equation are minus b plus r minus under root b square minus 4ac by 2a, and sum of the roots alpha plus beta is equal to minus b by a, product of the roots alpha beta is equal to c by a. So now by using this simple concept, many problems in our previous IIT mains questions I am going to explain some problems. Okay, the first one is, it's a very easy question. If alpha comma beta are the roots of x square minus 6x minus 2 is equal to 0, x square minus 6x minus 2 is equal to 0, if an is equal to alpha power n minus beta power n for n is greater than or equal to 1, then the value of a10 minus 2a8 by 2a9 is equal to how much? So previous mains question anamata, JEE mains question, idi mains question 2015 mains question. So now given that if alpha comma beta are the roots of that equation, and if an is equal to alpha power n minus beta power n for n is greater than or equal to 1, then the value of a10 minus 2a8 by 2a9 is equal to how much? We know that up to now very simple concept, just sum of the roots and product of the roots. By using that one only, here we are going to do this problem very simple way. Okay, so now here alpha comma beta are the roots of x square minus 6x minus 2 is equal to 0. So alpha is a root of x square minus 6x minus 2 is equal to 0. When it is the root of this equation, then this must satisfy the given equation. So that is alpha square minus 6 alpha minus 2 is equal to 0. Alpha square minus 2 is equal to 6 alpha. Similarly, beta is also a root of this equation. After that, we get beta square minus 2 is equal to 6 beta. And then after here, now we have to find out a10. An is equal to, given that alpha power n minus beta power n. So here n is, if we substitute n is equal to 10, a10 is equal to alpha power 10 minus beta power 10. a8 is equal to alpha power 8 minus beta power 8. a9 is equal to alpha power 9 minus beta power 9 by substituting instead of n, 10, 8 and 9. So now a10 minus 2 into a8 by 2 into a9 is equal. So here a10 is equal to how much? Alpha power 10 minus beta power 10 minus 2 into a8 alpha power 8 minus beta power 8 by 2 into a9 alpha power 9 minus beta power 9. So here like terms I am writing in a single bracket, that is alpha power 10 minus 2 alpha power 8 minus beta power 10 minus 2 beta power 8 by 2 into alpha power 9 minus beta power 9. So from here I am taking alpha power 8 common, alpha power 8 into what we get, alpha square minus 2 alpha, okay, alpha square minus 2 alpha, alpha square minus 2 only, okay, and alpha square minus 2 minus beta power 8 into beta square minus 2 by 2 into alpha power 9 minus beta power 9. So here alpha power 8 into alpha square minus 2 is equal to how much? Alpha square minus 2 is equal to 6 alpha. Here I am writing 6 alpha minus beta power 8 into 6 beta by 2 into alpha power 9 minus beta power 9. So here from this, in the numerator I am taking 6 common. So alpha power 9 minus beta power 9 by 2 into alpha power 9 minus beta power 9. These to get cancelled. So after that 6 by 2 is equal to 3 is the required answer. So just to, we are going to use just some of the roots and product of the roots. Simple concept. By using the simple concept only, we are going to do this type of problems. Very easy. Okay, right. So next question, I am going to explain next question. It is also previous mains question. Previous mains question, recently it came. It is also a very easy question. Suppose 2019, mains 2019. If one root of the equation, one root of the equation 81x square plus kx plus 256 is equal to 0 is cube of the other, is a cube of the other, cube of the other, then the sum of the, then the sum of the, sum of the values of k, values of k is, sum of the values of k is, sum of the values of k is. So here given that one root is cube of the other, just we have to observe the given equation, given question, we have to observe what is he given. So if one root is the cube of the other, that means suppose alpha is a root of the equation, then the other root is alpha cube anamata. So here alpha and alpha square, alpha and alpha cube are the roots of the given equation, roots of the given equation. So then sum of the roots, what about sum of the roots? Sum of the roots, ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0. If alpha comma beta are the roots of ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0, then the sum of the roots is equal to minus b by a, and product of the roots is equal to c by a. So here sum of the roots is equal to minus b by a, that is minus k by 81. So here k is equal to minus 81 into alpha plus alpha square, call it equation 1. And here product of the roots, alpha into alpha cube is equal to c by a, that is equal to 256 by 81. So that is alpha power 4 is equal to 256 by 81, that is equal to 4 by 3 all to the power of 4. So then we get alpha is equal to plus or minus 4 by 3 plus or minus 4 by 3. It is also very simple question. So now if alpha is equal to 4 by 3, then equation 1 becomes, so suppose k1 is equal to minus 81 into 4 by 3 plus 4 by 3 whole cube, right? 81 into 4 by 3 plus 4 by 3 whole cube here, 3 whole power 3. And next, if alpha is equal to minus 4 by 3, then k2 is equal to minus 81 into minus 4 by 3 plus minus 4 by 3 whole cube. So call it equation 2 and call it equation 3. So here k is nothing but sum of the values of k. Sum of the values of k means k is equal to k1 plus k2. K is equal to k1 plus k2. So by adding these two, if we observe that it is a negative value, it is a positive value. So negative, positive ends, we get the same numbers. So therefore this is equal to 0. 0 is the required answer. It is also very easy question. Just by we are going to use only sum of the roots and product of the roots only. Okay, na? Thank you.